A very good morning to my dear students of class 7 and I'm glad to welcome you all to today's zoology class. Today's class is going to be a revision video about chapter 3. What is chapter 3? Kingdom classification 2, right? That is classification of animals. So about this chapter only we are going to revise in today's class. So let's get started. Generally, animal kingdom are classified into two, called as invertebrates and vertebrates, right? So this chart is the classification chart for invertebrates. So invertebrates, so for learning this chart, we have an easy method. Just memorize this sentence: ponytail in this planet is an art of modern era. So here, invertebrates are first classified into PO stands for porifera, NI stands for cnidaria, PLA stands for platyhelminthes, NE stands for nematoda, AN stands for annelida, ART stands for arthropoda, MO stands for mollusca, and E stands for echinodermata. You cannot skip this table. You have to memorize this chart completely. You should know what are the classifications that come under the kingdom invertebrates. And 97% of the animal group includes invertebrates. Only 3% includes the group vertebrates. That also you should know this number, 97%. So now let's quickly revise about each group. We'll start with porifera. The term porifera stands for pores. That's why it has this name porifera, because the animals in this group will have pores, that is small openings throughout their body, and they will have a very large opening. And this, through this opening only, they will take in their food. And also it is a cavity. What is cavity? Cavity means an empty space where water and food can enter through. And this pore, can you see a large pore or hole? So through this pore, apart from taking in the food, the exit of wastes also occur. That is, they release out their waste also through the same pore only, but in the form of dissolved form, which means they are dissolved in water and it will be released out of their body. And then the habitat of porifera is aquatic. What is aquatic? Aquatic means they will live in water only, and especially in the marine environment and not in the freshwater environment. And for every group, you should memorize the examples, and in this case, porifera has two examples given in your textbook called Sypha and Eusporangia, belong under this group of porifera. So the next group is cnidaria. You can see two examples here. This is hydra and this one is jellyfish. Both these animals come under the group called cnidaria. Now let's quickly revise about the properties of these examples, and before that, the general properties of the group cnidaria we'll look upon. So their habitat is also marine. They do not live in fresh water. They can live only in salt water, and they can exist in two forms. That is, these organisms either will be attached to the ocean, which means the floor of the ocean will have soil, no, to that soil they will be either be attached, or some of them will be free floating. Free floating means they will not be attached to any place, but they will be floating about in the water. So cnidaria group can exist as a free floating ones or attached to the ocean bed. And then they have a soft body and translucent body. What is translucent? Translucent means it is not transparent. It is called semi-transparent. Partially they are transparent. Okay. So their body is soft, and see, it appears like see-through. No, you can see that side, the next side of the organism, when you see, that is why it is called as translucent body. It is soft and translucent, and it has an opening called as mouth. Can you see opening here? And there is also opening here, that is called the mouth for the group of organisms. And they have a single hollow body cavity. There is one cavity or empty space, and that is called the body cavity. See, for every group you should know the properties, because if I ask you list out the characteristics of cnidaria, you should know to explain all these points. So the key points you will memorize, clear? And also it is not that difficult. Just imagine the picture of the organism, you can just explain. Say for example, this is jellyfish, right? How I can explain the properties of jellyfish? It is like an inverted bowl. I'll list out so that you can see the properties. See, the property is like a inverted bowl, no? Just like how you put a bowl upside down, if you see itself, the appearance is there. What else you have? You have some hair like structures, that is called as tentacles. So they have tentacles. Why they have tentacles? They have tentacles to capture the prey. What is capturing of prey? Prey means the food for the jellyfish. So whenever the food is available, the tentacles only will surround the food and will capture them, will take the food. That is the purpose. So I told you already, this is jellyfish, right? So it is an example for a form which is free living form. I told you the group cnidaria itself can either exist as being attached to the floor of the ocean, or they can exist as free living forms. No, this jellyfish is an example for free living forms. They are not attached anywhere, but they just keep floating. It is an example for free living forms. Then this is hydra. What are the properties of hydra? It is a attached form. They are not free floating like jellyfish, but they are attached to some place. So hydra is such an example. What about the structure? What you have? The shape of the body is like a vase, like a flower vase, all you have, no? Similarly, the shape is like a vase, and they also have tentacles, but the tentacles are found in the upper region. See, in the case of jellyfish, the tentacles are in the lower side, no? Opposite to that, here in hydra, the tentacles are present on the upper side. So this is about cnidaria. The next group is platyhelminthes. So whenever you remember, spell out a group, no, just you have to remember one image. If you tell the word platyhelminthes, immediately this image should come in your mind. When you look at this image, how can you describe? This is flat, right? This is not cylindrical or round, it is just flat. So it is called as flat worm. It is a worm. Usually how worms appear, it has a cylindrical body, right? But this group will have is called as flat worms because it is flat in structure, and it also appears like a leaf. If we see, you know, it appears like the veins of a leaf and like a leaf, right? So the body appears like a flat leaf. What are the other properties? They are always parasites on animals or human. What does this mean? Parasite means they live inside an animal or inside a human being. They are not free living. They will depend other organism, either animal or human being, to live their life. Okay, and there you can find them. They can be found either in fresh water or in the sea water, marine or freshwater habitat. It can exist both in salt water or in fresh water, and they have one opening, and through this opening, can you see opening here? So this opening is a common opening for both food intake and also waste exit. Through one opening itself, it will take in the food and it will give out. Okay, so these are some of the properties of the group called flatworms or platyhelminthes. What about the next group? Then the next group is nematoda. Nematoda is also called as roundworms because these worms are not flat but the body is cylindrical in shape. Just like the previous flat worms, this also exists as a parasite. That is, they will need either an animal or a human being for their survival. They exist as parasites inside the human being or animals, or sometimes they can also exist in soil and water. And their digestive system includes two parts. One is called the mouth. One side has an opening, which is the mouth, and the second end, the next end, will have one more opening, and that is termed as anus. Even the opening for human being is the anus. Now, similarly, these worms also anus to release out their waste. And the examples are Ascaris and hookworms. All the examples you should memorize. Okay, for every group. Then we learn about the next, revise about the next group. Okay, this is Annelida. See, from this group, no, whatever we are going to revise till the end of this chapter, you must have seen in your day-to-day life. These worms, where can you see? You can see in the soil. If you dig the soil, no, these worms are common. Which group it is? It is called Annelida. By seeing the picture, how can you describe it? You can see segments, right? There are lines on the body. So, you can call it as segmented, and they have ring-like structures. I can also call that it is segmented. Or I can tell it is in a ring form. No, these rings has a name called as annuli. Annuli, okay, and it is long, and again it is cylindrical in shape. This is the appearance of the worm. Where it lives? Where can you find this worm? In the soil mostly, or sometimes even in the water you can find these worms. It also has two ends, similar to the round worms. Annelida group also have two openings, one the mouth and the anus, and they have chitin or underlying bristle like structures for locomotion. What does this mean? Like small legs, they have bristle like structures, and it is called as cheetah. Okay, and it is used for locomotion. Locomotion means movement, right? And then there are two examples given: earthworms, what you see in your day-to-day life, and also leeches. These are examples for the group called Annelida. The next group is Arthropoda. Example is cockroach. See, 80% of the insects what exist in this world, no, will come under the group called Arthropoda. Not insects, of the animal groups will include Arthropoda group. Okay, such a big group. What are the characteristics of cockroach? If I ask you where it is present, what is the habitat? Habitat means where it will live, right? Where can you find cockroach? It is terrestrial, which means it can live on the land, or it is aquatic, which means it can live in the water. Then how can you explain the body of the cockroach? It has a covering or exoskeleton. There is a covering on the body of the cockroach, no? That is called as chitin. It is made up of chitin, and it is proteinaceous. Proteinaceous means rich in protein, and that covering is called as exoskeleton. Exo means outside, skeletal means, you know, skeletal system, right? So exoskeleton, and it is made up of chitin. These all you should memorize. And the body of the cockroach is divided to three, called head, thorax, that is the middle region, and abdomen, that is the lowermost region. And they have antenna. Can you see two hair-like structures? It is called as antenna or antennae plural, and also compound eyes. There is a pair of eyes, no? It is compound eyes, and three pairs of jointed legs. Arthro means jointed, poda means leg. Okay, that's why it gets its name, Arthropoda. There are totally six legs or three pairs of legs. Three pair means one pair has two, right? So totally there are three pairs of jointed legs, which means, see, two legs are joined together. Can you see? They're all joined together. Two are linked together. That's why it is called jointed legs. This is about the group called Arthropoda. Then this group, snail also you must have seen in your day to day life, no? This group is called Mollusca. How can you describe snail? Where can you find snail? Snail is found either on the terrestrial habitat, that is land, or in the water also you can find. So it is called as aquatic habitat. What else you know about snail? What about the body? The body is soft and unsegmented. You should not talk about the shell or the outer covering. You should talk about only the body of the snail, which is soft in nature. The body is unsegmented, which means there is no partition or lines on their body. It just exists as a single segment. And the body is divided into three parts called head. This is the head, and visceral mass. That is, the body itself is called as visceral mass, and muscular foot, which is the mode of locomotion. That is, for the movement, they use their muscular foot. So these are the three parts of the snail, and also they are covered by a hard shell. You can see a shell outside, no? So that also you have to write when the qualities of molluscas are the characteristics you have to list out. Okay, what are the examples? So this snail, I already told you, it is a typical example. Apart from that, oysters and mussels also come under this group of mollusca. The next group is Echinodermata. For this you have to remember the starfish. So how can you describe a starfish? First of all, where it lives, it is found only in marine habitats. In freshwater you cannot find starfish. So the mode, the habitat where they live is marine habitat. And what about their skin? It is very tough, and they have spines on the surface of that shell like structure. And they have a central disc and five arms. Which is the central disc? This portion is called central disc, and these are all called the arms of the starfish. Okay, this also you have to mention. And they have a mouth on the lower side and anus on the upper side. So the upper region will have anus for passing out the waste, and the lower side will have the mouth through which they can intake their food. And they have feet which is termed as tube feet. See, every animal or organism will have foot or more something to move about, but it will be described through different terms. Here you call it as tube feet, no? In another animal it will be called by another term. So you should be familiar with their locomotory organs names also. So examples for Echinodermata group are sea urchins and brittle star. You have to memorize all the examples for every group. So that was about invertebrates, and the next classification is about the group vertebrata. Vertebrates have five subgroups called fishes, amphibians, reptiles, birds and mammals. We'll quickly look into the properties of these five groups also. So fishes, if you see, how can you describe a fish? Where fishes live? Fishes are aquatic inhabited, but it is, see, until this group, no, whatever we have seen before, either it lives in marine habitat or it lives in aquatic habitats, no? But this group fishes is both aquatic as well as it can survive in fresh water. There are also freshwater fishes. So both you have to mention. And their body is covered by scales, these white transparent scales. What you see on the outer covering is termed as scales, and they are streamlined body. What does this mean? Streamline means they can move along the water. Streamline word is also used for birds, because the word streamline means if an animal can move about freely without showing so much of resistance, either it can be either in water or in air, if it can move about freely without exhibiting so much of resistance against the movement, then it is called streamlined body. Fishes have streamlined body, which can easily move along with the water without resisting too much. And also birds can move about freely in the air because they too have a streamlined body. And they have gills to breathe and fins to swim. These all you know. but you have to mention, if I ask you list out the characteristics, you have to mention all the characteristics, and they are cold blooded organisms. What does this mean, cold blooded? See, human beings are warm blooded because what in wherever we move about, no, either to a very hot place, if you go to a desert or if you go to a place where there is ice, every time our body temperature is only 37 degrees centigrade, no? So if that is the case, then it is called as warm blooded organisms. Our body temperature will remain the same to wherever temperature we move about, no? So the organisms which have those characteristics are called warm blooded organisms. But cold blooded organisms, no, the temperature of their body will change as per the environment. So fish's body temperature will change about according to the water temperature. So it is called cold blooded organism. There are two types of fishes called bony fishes and cartilaginous fish. Bony fish will have skeleton bone, which means a hard bone, and the second group will have soft bones. Example for soft bone fishes, shark, and one example, there are many, but one example listed in your textbook for skeleton bone fishes are rohu. The next group is amphibians, that is frog group. It has this word amphi because amphi means two. It can live both on land and water, so it is termed as amphibians. So the habitat is both land and water. What about their body? It is moist and slimy in nature, like sticky nature you can find on their skin. And how do they breathe? You know, animals cannot find difficulty in breathing inside the water, right? But when they are in the water, they breathe through their skin, and when they are in the land, they breathe with the help of lungs. So they have two modes of breathing. And like the fishes, amphibians or frog group also are cold blooded animals. Their body temperature fluctuates. And about the life cycle of frogs, it exists in three stages called larval stage, tadpole stage, and adult stage. All the terms you have to keep in mind. So the examples for amphibians apart from frogs, which is given in your textbook, is salamanders. This also you have to learn. Then the next group is about reptiles. Where do reptiles live? They are also they also have the ability to live both on the land, that is they are terrestrial, as well as they can live in water, that is they are aquatic too sometimes. And the body is dry and scaly. Amphibians body is moist, no, but the reptile's body is always dry, and they also have scales like the fishes group. How do they breathe? They breathe with the help of lungs, just like human beings. Reptiles also breathe with the help of lungs. And again, they are also cold-blooded animals. The next group is about birds. Birds are called by a technical term as aves. Okay, so you have to use this word, aves. What are the properties of birds? I told you, no, just like the fishes, birds' body is also streamlined to move about in the air. And where do they live? Generally, they live on the trees. And why do birds fly? For in give reasons, no, this question is frequently asked. It doesn't mean that I'm going to ask this in your exam. Just read this. Why birds can fly? Birds can fly because they have hollow bones. Hollow bones means there is nothing inside their bones, so the body weight itself is so light, that's why they can fly, unlike the human beings. And they have four limbs which are modified into wings. They have four limbs, and the hind limbs only we call it as legs. The four limbs are modified in the form of wings with which they fly. And like human beings, birds are also warm-blooded animals. If I give you examples, if I ask you examples for warm-blooded animals, what all you will list out? You should list out birds and human beings, because these two groups only among the animal groups are warm-blooded animals. The rest others are cold-blooded animals. So keep that also in mind. So the examples of birds given in your textbook are sparrow and pigeon. The last group of vertebrates are mammals. Mammals, we are also mammals, right? Human beings are also mammals. What are the properties of mammals? Mammals are always terrestrial, which means we can live only on the land. We are not aquatic habitats. And mammals give birth to the young ones. Only this group of animal kingdom can give birth to their young ones and feed their young ones with the help of milk, which is secreted by mammary gland. This is a unique property of mammals alone. And they have two pairs of limbs, like birds also have two pairs of limbs, but the four limbs are modified into wings, no? But we have four limbs, which is called as hand, and hind limbs, which is the legs. And one more special property of mammals is only mammals will have fur in the case of animals, or in human beings, hair we call. So only the mammals will have fur or hair. And mammals are warm-blooded animals. Our body temperature is always constant and we breathe through the lungs. And examples for mammals are human beings, cows, dogs, cats, whale, bear. You can give any example. So this is a quick revision about the chapter 3, that is kingdom classification 2. So keep learning for your exams. Until I meet you in your next class, you all take care and bye bye.